Hello friends, welcome back. In the last video we have been seeing about how to calculate the baud rate for transmitter and receivers. So in this video we have been learnt about we can learn about some of the transferring of data from UART transmitter to an receiver. So before going to this, let me have an brief logic for this. FIFO, we need some of the four resistors. FIFO is the main basic thing in order to store the data. So whenever the UART is going to send an data to a receiver, so the receiver will be start processing the data. So during the processing time, if the UART sends another new data, in order to store that new data, we need to have some of a stack memory. So that is going to be accomplished by FIFO. You need FIFO, UART transmitter, UART receiver, and an LSR. So LSR for an line status resistor, in order to check whether UART have been successfully transmitted its information to FIFO. So the receiver have been successfully take the retrieve the data from an FIFO. So it is going to provide the status whether it has been successfully derived, delivered or not. So next one is, you are going to have an some of the three important resistors before going to coding for an UART. First one is FCR. In this, you are going to enable an FIFO, clear the receiver and transmitter of an FIFO. And next one is LCR, line control resistor. Here you are going to determine the data format of an transferring data. You are having an one stop bit. You are going to send an 8-bit data and you are going to enable the DLAB. So this DLAB is going to enable, because to get operate the DLL and DLLM. So this value is going to be get calculated by seeing an previous video which have been uploaded by me. Refer a previous video. So I have been provided the link for an in a description about a previous video. And the last one is LSR resistor. So this is the resistor which is going to tell whether the UART transmitter is free or not. If the transmitter is free, the fifth bit is going to be high. If the fifth bit is high, the transmitter is free. You can send any of the data using THR. If it is zero, mean to say and low, so UART is going to transmit any of the earlier information. So some already data is already transferring. So wait for full transaction. So if it becomes high, so the transmitter is free, you can send any of the data. So this is the initialization. You have been started with an ash include LPC17XX.h for initializing all the header files for operating of your 1768 microcontroller. So int main, your main program starts here. So you are having, so there is no need of this int type. So you have been transmitting a single character using an UART transmitter to a terminal. So terminal is a console window, an output terminal, etc. So at the first line, this is an optional one. It is necessary, it is optional one. If it is not included, your program will run and it is also going to provide an output as well. So next one is PCON. Pin select, you are going to select the UART 0. So you are going to select the UART 0. So UART 0 is going to have an TXD0 and RXD0 transmitter and receiver. So in order to do that, you need to search for TXD0. Okay, that is in pin select 0. So it is TXD0, RXD0. Here you are going to make this pin to work as an DX transmitter for an UART 0, for receiver as an UART 0. In order to make this feasible, you need to make this pin to function as 01. In order to make this, you need to write the 01 in a position 5 and 4. So 5 and 4, 0, 1. So 0 and 1. So the equivalent value of this is 50. So hence I have been written as 0000050. Here I have been taken UART 0 for and transmitting my data to a terminal. So next one, I have been speaking about this LCR resistor, line control resistor. You can search for this LCR. So LCR in a table 279. You are interested with selecting an 8-bit character length. In order to make this feasible, you need to write 1-1 in a position 0 and 1. So 1-1 in a position 0 and 1. So later you are interested with 1 stop bits. In order to make this feasible, write 0 at an bit 2. So write 0 at an bit 2. So next, you are not interested with any of this kind. You can just give 0 for 3, 4, 5 and 6. You are interested with division latch access bit. If you are going to enable this, you can access DLL and DLM. So that is being used in a later section of your program. So you are interested with making 7-1 and restore 0. So the equivalent number is 83. So you are going to write that 83 in a position UART 0 LCR. LCR stands for line control resistor. So next one is DLL. The value is being calculated as A2 and it is having a baud rate of 9600. In order to understand how you are going to calculate the baud rate, in a description you are going to get a link for a previous video. I have been told how to calculate the baud rate. So DLL and DLM is going to have that respective number. So later you are going to send an 8-bit of a dummy information before sending an original content. So last but not least, you need to have an another resistor. So that is FCR resistor. So as per the logic, you are having FIFO. At the very first step, you have been done. You are transmitter and receiver at this point. At this point, you have been calculated and transmitter and receiver. You have been configured the pin to work as an TXD0 and RXD0. Later, LCR, 8-bit character, 1-stop bit, and you have been enabled division latch enable. So DLL and DLM have been calculated by a previous video. You can refer the previous video. So LCR is for sending a dummy 8-bit character. So FCR is going to enable an FIFO and it is going to clear the transmitter and receiver of FIFO. So you can search for this FCR. So FCR is in a table 278. First you are going to enable an FIFO, that is in a bit 0. So bit 0 is enabled. So next, you are interested with clearing the receiver FIFO. So clearing the receiver FIFO bit 1. So clearing the transmitter FIFO bit 2. So bit 1 and bit 2 is going to be enabled. So rest are all 0. So the number here is 7. So FCR have been written as being 7 because you have been enabled FIFO. You have been taken, you have been clear transmitter and receiver of FIFO. So later one endless loop, and I have been told about the logic. You are going to check the THR. So this is the last one. So THR, you are going to check the fifth bit. If it is high, you are going to send the data. If it is low, you are going to wait. If it is zero, you are going to get wait. So I have been told that you need to check for the fifth bit. So you need to check for the fifth bit. So before checking the fifth bit, so you consider this is the status of this respective port. So this is my respective status. So that have been written here. So later I have been taken a fifth bit as an high. I have been performing an AND operation and I have been obtained the status of this fifth bit, whether it is high or low. In order to do this, I have been check the status of an LCR with an fifth bit. I have been perform an AND operation. If that fifth bit is equal to 1, so if this fifth bit is equal to 1, you can transmit the data. So if that fifth bit is 0, you are going to wait. So now fifth bit is 0, you are going to wait here. If this bit is 1, So AND operation, you are going to obtain an 1 here. So this 1 is going to be get compared with an 20, saying that 5th bit is high. If this 5th bit is high, you are going to send an single bit of an character to THR. So THR is going to transfer the, so THR is a transmitter old resistor, it is going to transfer the data to an FIFO. You can see this in your debug session. So you can go for and debug. So have this enable of an serial window. You can find the serial window and click an Uart one. So just execute this, you can see this character A is going to be get displayed. So this is all about how to send a single bit character to an terminal using an UART. So please do subscribe for the channel. Please do share. Please do subscribe. Keep supporting. Thanks for watching this video.